We're looking to work with 125 courses over the next 5 years, redesign it to make it a better student experience, to kind of future-proof them, to be delivered possibly in more flexible modes in the future. We also want to make the courses more active where we can, give them an increased opportunity to socialize with each other online.
I teach Marketing Fundamentals, which is the gateway course in the School of Marketing for the marketing major. And this semester, we've totally overhauled the course to make it digitally enabled. So that supports personalized learning. And we've used tools like Groupa for systematic group allocations. We've used the student engagement system for personalized feedback. We've used Moodle and we've used Connect with their digital platform.
They just talked about online lectures and how they've been customized for the students' needs and hopefully to also improve student outcomes. Basically, the view is that the students will find it useful and as an additional resource for them to improve their learning as well.
The Inspired Learning Initiative is a $77 million grant for a five-year piece of work looking at a number of different domains to enhance the student learning experience at UNSW. One of the principal components of it is the digital uplift, taking 330 blended and 330 fully online courses across the 8 faculties at UNSW to change the learning experience and to cater to the personalized needs of students coming into our system.
The blending process was to produce videos so that students could watch videos before coming to class to remove the chalk and talk element. The videos that I set up were in a number of different parts, outlining what the key learning objectives were for the week.
Office 365 has recently been made available for all staff and students. It offers a number of great learning and teaching tools within that product set, and it allows students and staff to collaborate on documents. That's able to allow them to actually move away from lectures in many cases because they're able to deliver that in an interactive way online.
With the face-to-face class, what we did was ask them to capture their discussions in Office 365, both by using photographs, videos, but also the tasks that they had outside of the classroom, and it gave them a way to capture this, and I could see how much work was being done and what was prepared and also the output of each class.
I felt that as my university life progressed, there was more and more of that digital aspect to the learning, and I feel that's continuing to grow, and I think that's a great thing.
There's more and more use we're seeing of the likes of Sway, for example, which is a digital storytelling app that allows students to embed content and make it really engaging and interactive and share it with their peers versus a traditional type assessment which might be only text-based. They can have video and other elements added to that. These are tools that students will be using in the future. They'll go into workforce and a lot of industry now is using these types of tools, so it's really important they get a grasp and increase their digital literacy.
The feedback from students and also the teaching team has been outstanding, and it's all been because of those digital tools that we've put in, and we've been able to create interconnected learning blocks for the students to progress seamlessly throughout.
Is there a need to move online? There's a generational effect that's happening right now in our hallways, in our classrooms. The generational Z students are with us, the millennials have left. Gen Z students use their mobile devices in very different ways, and they expect to have their learning catered to them, personalized for them, on their mobile devices. Going online provides that for them.